Best portable printers are dependable devices that let you print out documents while on the road. They're also great for printing photos directly from your smartphone or for homes or offices where space is a premium. In this video, we are going to take a look at the best portable printers for business you can buy. Links to all products mentioned in the video are available in the description. If you have other products you'd like us to review, please tell us in the comments below or visit 9to5printers.com. Canon PIXMA IP110. The Canon PIXMA IP110 with LK62 portable kit with battery offers high-quality prints and powerful battery rated to last 600 pages. Print speeds are not lightning quick, but image quality is high and printing costs are low with the Canon IP110. The IP110 delivered high-quality prints across the board. Color graphics on plain paper and glossy photos looked very attractive. Colors were well saturated, textures looked smooth, and details were sharp. Text quality was also good, with dark letter forms and well-defined edges, though up close, the edges looked slightly bumpy. Overall, the IP110 printed at roughly average or slower than average speeds. It printed 5 text pages in 40.8 seconds, or 7.4 ppm. Which was faster than the 6.9 ppm average for all portables tested. Running on battery power, this printer did not slow, keeping its 7.4 ppm pace intact. The Canon was slower than the average of 2.4 ppm on mixed color graphics and text, printing 6 pages in 2 minutes and 49 seconds, or 2.1 ppm. The IP110 was somewhat slow to make 4x6-inch glossy photo prints. Printing over USB from a PC using default settings, the IP110 made a photo print in 1 minute 45 seconds. From an iPhone over wireless network, the time was nearly identical. At best quality settings, printing a photo from the PC took 2 minutes and 21 seconds. The HP OfficeJet 250 was significantly faster, printing a 4x6-inch glossy photo in 37.6 seconds and 49.5 seconds respectively. 2. Epson Workforce WF110. Once charged, the WF110's battery will last for about 100 monochrome prints or 50 color pages, and of course, it will run indefinitely on AC power. It will not, however, charge over USB while in use. Epson also offers an add-on external battery that increases the cordless printing life by about an additional 500 prints. You'd expect a basic paper path with a printing this small, and that's exactly what you get. A 20-sheet input tray that can also hold 1 number, 10 envelopes or 5 sheets of photo paper. However, the OfficeJet 200 comes with a 50-sheet input tray, allowing you to print longer without replenishing paper. The WF110's standard connectivity interfaces include wireless 802.11, connecting to a single PC via USB 2.0 and Wi-Fi Direct. That last one is a wireless peer-to-peer protocol connection that supports mobile devices, allowing them to connect to the printer without an intermediary network. Other mobile connectivity options include Apple AirPrint, Google Cloud Print, Fire OS support, and Mopria print services. You also get Epson Email Print, Epson Remote Print, Epson Print and Scan, Epson Photo Scan, Epson Scan to Cloud, and Epson iPrint through the Epson Connect collections of apps. iPrint allows you to print, scan, and share photos, emails, web pages, Microsoft Word documents, Excel spreadsheets, PowerPoint files, and PDF documents directly from your phone or tablet. It also supports Box, Dropbox, Evernote, Google Drive, and Microsoft OneDrive cloud services. 1. Brother MFC J4620DW. Styled with Brother's bold black and white lines, the machine looks smart and modern, if a little wide. This is a result of Brother's unique technique of feeding A4 sheets in landscape mode, which reduces the necessary depth of its printers and increases their speed. On the downside, it also increases the noise levels, more on that later. A panel in the fully flat top of the machine flips open to reveal a 20-sheet automatic document feeder or ADF. There's a flat scanner as well, and a fold-out control panel that's centered around a 93mm touchscreen. This is bright and sensitive, although not up to the sensitivity of a typical smartphone. It offers access to the printer's main functions and also to online features such as printing from storage sites such as Dropbox. To the panel's right, there is a place to tap your mobile device for a quick connectivity using NFC. To the left of the control panel is a flip-down cover with USB, SD, and memory stick slots behind it. That's the end of that chapter. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. It really grinds my gears.